One of the more interesting stories that we have in the book of Joshua is the story of Joshua and the Gibeonites. We get word in Joshua 9 that the Gibeonites hear of Joshua's conquest Ai and Jericho, and that those conquests make the Gibeonites fear that Joshua's gonna come after them. Now, what's interesting about that story is that they come and sort of trick Joshua into this peace treaty, and he agrees. The reputation of Joshua reaches the Amorite kings, and 5 Amorite kings get together to come against the Gibeonites and in a sense also come against Joshua. And this is the story that we often read and talk about the sun standing still. But the geography of this story actually gives us a slightly different picture. As Joshua works his way west, it says that he marches with his people all night and they end up at Gibeah, which means that he probably gets to Gibeah right at sunrise. Now, what's interesting about that is we have his prayer. We have his prayer that the sun will stand still over Gibeon and that the moon will stand still over the Ayalon Valley, which is west of Gibeah. Now, if we take into account that the sun rises in the east and the moon sets in the west, what's interesting about this story is not that Joshua is asking for more sunlight, he is asking for more darkness, that the moon stands still in the west so that he can surprise attack the Amorite kings, and that the sun stay in the east as it rises so that it faces into the eyes of his enemy. These elements to the story, when we put them in the historical context of the Central Benjamin Plateau, offers a different reading and allows us to access the Bible at a deeper level.